solve the problem when danger is better.
Far away when
Casey.
Fuzzy the Bear.
To take the help at this point, and Casey chose not to. So he better be right.
That's a T5. But he didn't want help.
Strange and shizzy boy, they say he traveled very far, very far, over land and sea. A little shy and sad of eye, but very wise.
I think he made a mistake cutting his hair. Because see, before he had kind of a cool edge to it.
Yeah, now he's just really geeky. But not like geek chic geeky. Just like 100% geeky.
Exactly. And of course, is that a pink?
I think it's just
an upright face. I could see him taking Mike Myers' spot in I Married an Axe Murderer.
Oh, yeah.
That's about it. It's funny when they follow the camera. I don't know what I think about it. I mean, it's more him.
Yeah, I can't give him that.
But he's just not good. He's kind of campy.
He needs to borrow Paul's Crest White Strips. His teeth are looking yellow. And I'm not saying everyone's teeth are perfect, but if I was on TV and there's a camera zooming on my mouth, it kind of...
Who's White Strips?
Paul's!
Who's Paul again?
The guy's teeth are... looks like he's in a toothpaste commercial.
Oh. Alright, so they're gonna love it.
Well, they love it even when he stinks, so they're gonna love it when he's half decent.
What's he doing?
He's
celebrating anybody? Sci-fi or anything?
I mean, I guess it wasn't like karaoke, like it was better than.
Well,
Stefano.
He was at least original, but the problem is.
But who's gonna.
He's not original to us anymore.
Right.
What is he celebrating? Like.
He's wearing an ascot.
Casey! I don't know what ascot is.
Is that scarf you think?
At the beginning, I was nervous. I was like, oh my god, he's not going to win any popularity contest with this song. But as it goes on, it made me, I really started thinking, and I thought, you know, what's beautiful about this season is that we have gospel, rock, country, pop, jazz. We have all of it. Okay, and what makes a really, really great artist is that being an American Idol, you don't have to be a pop star. You don't have to be Elvis or Michael Jackson or Madonna. You can be Norah Jones and have a jazz album that sells 70 million copies, one album, and multiple Grammys, and the music itself crosses the boundaries. And
but you don't even need that. Look at
them. Because that's what you do. You bring that type of special thing to music.
Like that Beretta in your hair.
Good job. That's good job.
Nice. Isn't that special?
Crazy, right? I resent the fact that he got
Jennifer's
saved.
So, right, man. What I'm
so
happy
I can't ever like
this
him.
Season, man, is that we have real, true artists on the show. I don't think we've ever had anybody exactly like you ever. I mean, the fact that you're giving like a Grammy kind of performance that you could have been performing with, I know Ray was playing, but Herbie Hancock or whomever, and you're like Charles Mingus.
Yeah,
these are all names and stuff people don't realize, but I hope America gets this, because what I'm loving this season, it's about education and it's about embracing who you are. This guy is a jazz kind of artist. I could see him making kind of an extended kind of Bublé kind of record. And these records, there's a place for this and a place for you. I thought it was brilliant, man. I thought it was absolutely genius.
Well, he's been a big fan. You know, because he's a bass guy.
I know.
What it does to me, who's an artist, it makes me proud to sit here and judge artists as well as pop stars.
When she used a Nora Jones comparison, I actually could see that more than like a Blake.
We need art to have that same balance.
Casey, man, you are an artist, the truest sense of the word. You took a song, Annette King Cole, who sang Chemo, Chemo, Stare, Stare, Mahi.
Oh, it's not King. Okay, so that's the old. All right.
Like I said, though, Steven Tyler knows stuff.
He's old. I mean, he's been around a long time. He's going to know.
Well, I'm surprised he knows that much stuff, being a juiced up rocker. What's that?
Growing as an artist, I don't know how anybody here could say that they're not. The fast-paced work that we're doing, and the experience of meeting all these producers, there's no way I could ever say I'm not growing in a tremendous way.
She seems a little,
really crazy to think that the only two of us girls
like hasn't been likable.
You definitely gotta work hard, and you gotta fit... in
and I don't know why.
Song. You gotta find that niche that'll get you on the comfy side, man. I decided to go with Blondie's Call Me, which is also featured in the movie American Beauty.
Kind of good for her.
I like that song.
I love that song.
If she doesn't like that, that'd be cool.
To be able to learn how to, because there's like a split second for a breath.
Yeah, but it's a shot. You gotta hit that note.
Right.
It shows your pipes. And it brings the energy up. It's hard to do a song by such a stylist as Debbie Harry.
Haley now has
to transform herself not into Debbie Harry, but into a personality and a character equally as powerful.
But they seem to not do it their own way. With the exception of Fuzzy Bear.
Yeah.
And I hope you guys really dig it.
But I'm with you, I don't like Fuzzy Bear. Let's see if she's good. See, it sounds just like karaoke.
Right.
Sounds just like her. She could take the role of Debbie Harry. I don't like this arrangement, but she's doing it well. This is the best performance I've seen her do. You know what she has that I just realized that Pia didn't have? Because she's got a formidable voice like Pia. In my opinion, she could probably hold her own against Pia. But she's got more expression in her body.
Oh, of course she does, yeah.
Right there.
Yeah.
She's still gotta work on that left arm. Her left arm's awkward. It's like hanging off her body for no reason. Like she doesn't know what to do with it. It's like a weird left arm. It's like, I don't know what to do with this left arm. There we go. I think she should have done it slow though, like she was doing with the recording with the piano. I thought that would have been cool. Like that was too much like Blondie would do it.
I know.
At times I thought she sounded like Blondie.
Steven's yelling at me, come on, but come on, come on. Listen, honest, I didn't love the beginning of it. At the end, you started kind of getting into the song.
It started kind of
karaoke to me because, like, I don't know if it was the song choice that didn't really do it for me. A singer song at this point to show what you really have up there and why you should stay in this to win it and the whole thing. It just wasn't a showcase for your voice for me. So I don't know. Stevie, what do you think, man?
I agree, but I've always said that when you sing choruses and you nail them in that just right song, this song is like a chorus. The coming!
It was beautiful. You sang it heavy, you sang it great. I love that. That split, that thing you got on is gorgeous too. Here's her looking up your old address.
Thank you.
Girl.
Yes, I love it when you start wailing at the end and everything. If I'm gonna be totally honest, I'm gonna agree more with Randy, except I'm so afraid to say anything about any of the girls because I don't want any of the girls to go home. I feel like all the girls are getting voted up and I don't like that. I really want, we have strong girl singers and I feel they deserve to be here. Yes, girls, vote!
It does all five of the girls are
two killer performances like you just gave, baby, you gotta just keep taking it higher and higher and higher. You're earning your place here. I said last week you were a contender. You are. You're a contender to win. So let's keep it at that level.
That sucks.
Think about that when you're choosing your songs.
She did better than that Spanish guy. I forgot his name. That you call Italian.
I think she's good. I've always said about her, she has a really good voice, but she annoys me. I've been saying this at the beginning. I don't know.
It's that left arm.
Oh, God.
That left arm drives me crazy. Uh-oh.
Get more starch, go a meal. You don't need corn.
Wait a minute. Anybody seen Bridge Over Troubled Waters yet?
Man, you know what
this is? No. That was made for you, that record.
At first, I didn't care for Will.
Isn't that funny, though?
But I'm kind of enjoying him. Like, I don't think he sings, so I don't think he should be here.
He's a producer.
But yeah, he's obviously...
This week, I am singing Bridge Over Troubled Water from the movie The Pursuit of Happiness. It's a big song. It's a very big song. Hopefully, the record likes it.
He's coming across a little cocky. It's a big song, but I'm a big guy. He's kind of like... I love that you look at the camera. But I guess he's got a feel cocky because he is gone. It's kind of just him in the rocker. As far as the voice.
Yeah.
But I think he's kind of getting boring now. Of course they're going to love it. He starts to scream a little bit more than he used to. I just found three tears. That's pretty cool. There's only one other person I know that can do that.
Solve the problem when danger